Good morning, everyone. Happy St. Patrick's Day 2013. I'm hanging out here March 17th with Fox Colton, and we're just kicking it. This is part two of the interview, but it's a real casual interview. We just kind of stumbled up to the topic of the beauty of randomness, and I was telling Fox about a couple music videos that I was creating where something spontaneous happened and these crazy people showed up and just made the video, and you were telling me about some of your experiences on the road and in between shows and stuff like that.
Oh yeah, just random occurrences that a person stumbles into when traveling from place to place.
Yeah, I mean, we could be sitting here talking and then all of a sudden something happens.
Yeah, you know, somebody completely randomly walks up. I'm trying to think of a good example. You know, once in Taos, New Mexico, actually, this is a long story that I thought. I didn't know where I was going when I was in Williams, Arizona. I was actually at a Lakota Sundance. Or actually, I believe they were Lakota, or of Lakota descent. I know it's not Lakota territory. But I had a deck of cards that somebody I met on the bus had given me at random. I didn't know where I was going. I had no idea which direction to take next. I didn't have anything booked at the time. I was trying to start booking for, you know, coming month. And I shuffled the cards, and I decided that if the next card was red, I was going to go northeast. And if it was black, I was going to go southeast. And it came out red, and it was King of Diamonds. And I wasn't gonna, you know, base my life on a card, so I reshuffled and I pulled it again just to be sure, and it was a Queen of Diamonds. So I went northeast. And whenever I didn't know where to go, I just looked for something red. And one day in Albuquerque, a random guy came up to me and he kept telling me how much I would love Taos, New Mexico, and how I have to see Taos, New Mexico. And I really didn't give a rat's ass about the guy. At a glance, he was just some random crazy guy who walked up to me telling me about Taos. And all I could think of the whole time he was talking to me was what a horrendously red shirt he had on that was like hurting my eyes. It was so bright. So I went to Taos. And I ended up in Taos, New Mexico during the last rash of wildfires that were going through New Mexico. And I ran into a friend of mine from San Diego there completely at random. She was traveling through. And she offered me a ride up to Raton to catch the train. But her car broke down. So somebody we met randomly in a coffee shop gave us a number of a friend of hers who could fix her car. And the guy drove up after we called him, tied the car to the bumper of the tow strap, and then took us out into the middle of the desert where his compound was. To make a long story short, we ended up stuck there for about a week and a half because due to the fires, shipping was altered, or hindered rather, and they couldn't get the right piece to the car shipped into Taos. So we ended up stuck there, and Taos had been evacuated due to the state of emergency. We had flames on, not literally on all sides of us, but on all sides, you know, within a few miles, and they were about to engulf this local power plant, and everybody was, you know, up in a tizzy screaming that, you know, be a nuclear holocaust of some sort was going to befall Taos. And we just had to sit there and watch it rain ash and embers until the car was fixed. We waited a week and a half. And as a result of that adventure, I decided to buy land in Taos, which I'm actually in the process of shopping for right now. And everybody who I met in Taos had the same story of how they got there. And it was that their car broke down and they just decided to stay. That's my random red card / Taos story.
That's
go
an
to
awesome,
Taos, New Mexico.
That's an awesome story. You know, and right where you're sitting is where I wrote a song called Infinitesimal Decimal. And I wrote that song because on the way in, I reached in my pocket and a little vocabulary practice card fell out and it had the word infinitesimal in it.
I like that.
And that's when I came up with the song. Some of you may have heard it, but I just love the beauty of randomness. You know, I'm teaching a cognitive psychology class right now. We're going to use this video just to, as a conversation starter, to talk about randomness, because one of the things I complain about in terms of the way cognitive psychology is presented is that everything is about prediction and control, and people are like studied as objects or like in a very mechanistic way. Something called mechanomorphism, where where researchers project, you know, mechanical features onto living, breathing creatures and just suck the life out of them in the process. Mm-hmm. So I like the idea of introducing a subject called randomness into a field like cognitive psychology, where everything is so overly controlled and everything is about putting something in a test tube and observing it from a distance, you know, which it's impossible to be objective. You know, once you step into the mix, you're part of the situation or the problem or whatever. So I even thought of an idea for a song as we were talking about that story called Red Shirt.
Okay.
Maybe we could co-write it sometime.
All right. I like that.
It's your story, so. Anyway. Okay, everybody, I've been talking to Fox, and you've been listening to us just hang out and chat. This is part two of our interview. I like the cool stuff on your around your neck. Where'd you get that?
This is a coyote spine that I found in Williams, Arizona, actually, when I was hiking from Flagstaff to Williams with the kid I met on the bus who ended up giving me a deck of cards. The reason that I put so much stock into that deck of cards is because I met this kid at random on the bus, and he decided to walk with me from Flagstaff to Williams because he wanted to go to the Sundance. He made it about 3/4 of the way through and decided he couldn't walk anymore and gave me a deck of cards as a thank you for the adventure. And then I specifically told him that I didn't like playing cards, and he still gave it to me anyway. So I decided that its only use was to predict the future. That was it. But anyway, cool. Found this on that hike. That is a hawk talon that somebody gave me in New Orleans, but apparently it was roadkill in Texas. And this rabbit foot, as a matter of fact, I cut off of a rabbit in Taos, New Mexico. And there's a video on YouTube that says Taos Rabbit Hunt. It's one of my videos. And it's a video of my friend Dusty, who I met during this adventure in Taos. And you can actually see the sky is pretty dark from all the fires around in the background of that video. And they were out hunting rabbits because they were eating the crops. And then they keep the skins to make furs for the winter, and they feed the rabbits to the dogs. But anyway, they didn't have anything to do with the feet, so I cut one off and kept it. And I've had it ever since.
It's lucky, and today's St. Patrick's Day.
Wasn't lucky for the rabbit.
No, I'm not. Everybody's luck is based on someone else's misfortune, right? Thanks for listening, everybody, and be sure to check out Fox on Reverb Nation. Check out Dr. BLT while you're at it. I'm old, but I like to still consider myself semi-relevant. See you later.